My name is Mimi Pond, and I'm a cartoonist. My dad was an amateur cartoonist. He taught me how to draw. He showed me at a very early age cartoon compilations, and you know, it just formed my idea of what I wanted to do from an early age. And they saw that I had drawing talent, and they kept saying, "She's going to be a cartoonist." I was like, "Yeah, that's good." So when I was a kid, I grew up in San Diego, and because of Mad Magazine, I knew there was a thing called summer camp, but there was no summer camp at all in our lives. My summer camp was my mother would just pack my brother and me off to the movies. You know, you'd buy a giant roll of tickets and you'd be set for the summer. And I'd watch old Busby Berkeley musicals, and there were all these little bars that lined the main street of our neighborhood. And I'd just imagine in my mind that each of those tiny bars inside expanded ginormously, and there was a dance floor and a big band. Fred Astaire and Ginger were gliding across the floor, and you go in there and have the most glamorous time, and it was all being withheld from me. And I just was like, oh, if only I could go in there. There were so few movies that showed the lives of girls that when I saw one, it really stuck with me. So Crime of Miss Jean Brody, and The World of Henry Orient, and A Tree Grows in Brooklyn, and also National Velvet. They're all about the lives of girls.
You girls are my vocation. I am dedicated to you in my prime.
And there's these really important messages in both National Velvet and A Tree Grows in Brooklyn, where the mothers have these conversations with their daughter where they tell them it's good to be ambitious and I want these things for you.
I was 20 when they said a woman couldn't swim the channel. You're 12. Your dream has come early.
There just weren't enough movies like that for girls when I was growing up. I got out of school and I needed a job, so I went to work as a waitress in this really crazy, funky restaurant, and it turned out to be a fantastic place to work. I decided to see it as a role I was playing, and Jody Gilbert, she's just a minor Hollywood character actress, spars with W.C. Fields in Never Give a Sucker and Even Break, like a complete pro. She's just breathtaking.
You're as funny as a cry for help.
All the great movie waitresses like Joan Blondell and Joan Crawford were tremendously inspiring to me, because then I could just be a tough-talking, hard-boiled waitress.
Listen, baby, I'm APO.
What does she mean, APO?
Ain't putting out.
And at the end of the day, I'd take my apron off and go home and be an artist instead. I knew there was a story in it because there were so many compelling characters. My latest project is a graphic novel all about Britain's famous Mitford sisters. They were six sisters, five of whom did a whole bunch of stuff they probably shouldn't have done. They literally went everywhere and did everything, and they were very, very funny. I was drawing on movies from the 1920s and 30s and 40s for my book because I wanted to capture the look of the time and place in which their lives were happening, and the glamour of the 20s and 30s. And of course, Busby Berkeley movies, there's no better place to start than that. So there's just a huge wealth of visual material from movies to draw on for that. Sorting through all of that and then trying to organize it is one thing. And then once it's organized, then I have to figure out what's the best way to present it visually that isn't just rote or boring. You know, I want each page to like really pop. So I'm really not satisfied until I come up with something that I'm going to be excited to draw and to show to other people. I find so much joy in drawing by hand. That's part of the magic for me, is, you know, making the original art. And that's something that just doesn't happen with computers. And, you know, I don't care how much easier it is. I got my whiteout. And once I'm done, we do nothing but watch TCM every night. Whether it's a Bikini World or the Red Shoes, there's always something to take away from these experiences, because they just give you kind of a deep, deep dive into film in a way that other channels don't. It's interesting because I've been going to San Diego Comic-Con since I was like 12 years old. And on first glance, my feeling of the film festival was like, oh, this is just like Comic-Con, but for movie nerds. But then I became aware that the TCM Film Festival, you had just absolutely passionate film buffs, people who just devote themselves to the study of movies of all kinds. And I realized, you know, once I was amidst them, I was like, this is my tribe. I found my tribe. I would recommend absolutely studying film because there's no better visual medium for storytelling than the movies. I'm Mimi Pond, and the movies made me do it.